redoing this video with a microphone this time, so hopefully it's a bit better. We're putting a 12 valve Cummins in this thing. We haven't got too far yet. Obviously the motor's out already, and the motor's been stripped at the moment, and it's been sent to the machine shop just to be bored out. We pulled it apart and we weren't really happy. So I'm still waiting on pistons to rock up for that. As soon as they're here, I've got to take them down to them so they can measure them and bore it. We've got the 4080 that we're putting in. So we're ripping out the 5-speed manual because for reliability purposes. So I've got, it's a 12 valve, it's a P-pump 12 valve. I bought as a running core. So it had a slight bit of blow by. Good oil pressure, and that's basically all that they could tell me. So I got it reasonably cheap. It only cost me about $5,000 delivered here in Perth, and that's come from California or wherever. All the adapters are all purchased in the kit with the gearbox, so it's CEM adapters from Roland, and that's pretty much all ready to be bolted together once that engine's back together. Got most of the, pretty much all the other parts, ARP head studs and whatnot, to put the motor back together. So we're just waiting on these pistons, and then we should be able to actually make some progress. It's been a while since anything's happened really. I've just cut these engine mounts off just the other day. I'm still going to tidy up this engine bay. There is a fair bit I can do in between, which I'm going to start doing now. Like interior wise as well. Obviously I'll get rid of the manual surround. I've got an auto surround for that. And then I will be sound deadening the cab because obviously it is a noisy motor. I've got the ping jing sound deadening over there. Chinese stuff. Should hopefully do the job.
You did this. And drove the fucking thing actually to Cowberry. I'm like, you got a fucking death wish, mate. I don't think that one, mate. I'm just hearing it. But...
Alright, so we got some ping jing stuff. It's just sound deadening to go on the inside of the tunnel. Well, I'm going to see how well it sticks. The inside of the car's going to get more of it. Does have factory sound deadening, but I thought it blocks a bit of heat as well, so I'll try and get some on the firewall once I figure out where the engine's going, and then see if that stops with the noise and heat, obviously being loud and whatnot being a tractor. And then I'll chuck a link for that stuff. It's pretty good. I used it in my GQ and it made quite a lot of difference, mainly in road noise. But I'm just going to see how it goes in this thing. Pack it anywhere I can, basically. Another handy thing is this trim puller kit. It's just got all sorts of stuff to basically pull the trims off your car rather than breaking every single thing that you try and pull off. Not sure how well you're going to hear the difference on camera, but compared to... Gonna move on to the engine build just as it sits. We'll be right back. do you have to put that rounded side to the piston?
Just spit it up a sharp edge pushing out. If you've got a rounded edge, there's a chance of it popping out, but it's just generally a rule of thumb. It probably wouldn't make much of a difference, but it's just the way you get taught by little Chinese men.
In all bearings, obviously, are all new. We've then thrown the, what did we do? Drop the cam in, obviously. New oil pump's gone in, new water pump's gone in. Obviously, the fuel pump has gone on here. We've done the fuel pump mods, so different springs, different amounts of boost. And they say, you know, so you got a stock one. One with added fuel, larger single turbo, which is what I went for. It says 35 to 45 PSI. And then you got compound turbos, 45 to 60 PSI.
And then these?
These are just all the air fittings. Why is there oil in there? Anywho, so obviously to wire this controller, that's the in-cab controller. So that'll just go on the cab. It's got power and fuel rate, and then a switch there. That's just like max fuel. It's literally just two air lines that get wired to the AFC housing. And then you've basically got in-cab control. It's got a little boost dial on there, boost gauge. So that'll be interesting to see how that goes. So that's rear freeze blank, obviously just to replace that tap-in Welsh plug. That tappet cover or whatever, or push rod cover. It's got a crappy tin one on there from standard that always leaks, so that's a good replacement if you're doing the same thing Same with the freeze plugs. They're all the bolt-in style ones, other than the block heater as well, which stays. So regarding the head, we've done valve springs. I've gone and done heavy-duty collets, or whatever you want to call them, spring retainers. I don't think you need them, but again, I'm here. So ARP head studs, so an issue that we've run into. I was told that you just had to make the threads deeper or make them longer, like the blind hole in the block was deep enough, but you just needed to tap the threads in a little bit more, which I don't understand, because working out that the tensile rating of the bolt, like you've got enough thread without tapping it, but we tapped it anyway. And then we've gone, put the head on, and the actual valve cover, individual covers, don't actually fit on anymore. So they actually protrude too much by the time we put the nut on it. And there's actually a washer now as well. The box didn't actually come with instructions, but I've got them up online as we were doing it. And then it does actually say you need to machine, I'll put a video in that, you have to machine the like rocker cover gear on top just so that it actually bolts and sits lower, obviously giving you the clearance on the valve cover. So that's something that's I'm waiting on now, that's been sent out. They're machined, and then other than that, it's all ready to go together and actually torque the head down then. At the moment, the head's just sitting on it. But we've got this dodgy looking frame welded up. It's pretty bloody sturdy, it's not gonna go anywhere, so. We just sat the motor on there, because I think our idea, as you can see, there's no front diff. I reckon that we'll, because I'm going with the PSR long arms, I reckon we can drop the car sort of over the engine on this, and then bolt the engine mounts in, tack, and then pull it back off and weld them up. So we've obviously bolted the gearbox there to the motor, and then added another brace for that. So, fingers crossed, it actually works pretty well when we just drop it down. PSR long arms, I was hoping that they'd get in here this week, but I don't know, I'll have to give them a ring tomorrow. Still got the diff brace, chassis brace, and the hydraulic bump stop to go on there as well, so. Bit of work to do. We're getting there. At least the engine's all pretty much back together. Like I said, just need to get these rocker gears back, and then torque my head down. And a couple more accessories. Lift pump, I'm gonna see, most people get rid of the factory lift pump for exhaust clearance, but I'll see if I can keep that, because it will be handy. It'll save me having to buy an electric one, plumb it up from probably the back of the car. I'd rather just keep the factory mechanical one rather than going electric and spending another $1,500 on one. So there are cheaper ones, but if I'm gonna do it, to do it right, and I'll probably buy the better one for it. So I'll probably whack it on for now and see how it goes. Once it's in the car, if it clears, it clears. I know at least one bloke's done them, and he's got his exhaust passed, but we'll just see. Oil coolers still gonna go on. Obviously the manifold and the turbo can go on once it's in the car. It'll give us more clearance as we drop the car over it anyway. We've done the measurements and it should drop straight over it pretty fine, so. And then just the timing cover, which I'll need to paint. And obviously the accessories on the front, fan, aircon, whatever. There is a relocation bracket that I don't know if I'm gonna need or not, that actually relocates your aircon and alternator. It brings it in a bit closer, and it brings the aircon compressor up top rather than down the bottom, giving you more clearance off the chassis. But again, that's just something that I'll cross the bridge when we get to it. I know people have done it without it, and people say that they would definitely recommend getting it, and others say they have no drama, so.
on the bolt.
Next episode, so I'll wrap it up now so that I can just actually get stuff in the next one. Got the motor done, minus the manifolds to bolt on. If you're following the Instagram, you've probably seen that we've now ripped the cab off the chassis, so we just decided that that'd be better off, a lot easier to finish off the work that we've now, at least now we've got the engine mounts in, and we've actually got the position relative to the body. So now that we've got that, we can sort of sit that motor on the chassis and then do all the major work that needs to be done, mainly tidying up and painting all the bracing that we've done. I don't know if I'll put that in this video or the next one. You might have already seen that. But yeah, I'll chuck in the description the links to the Instagram and TikTok and whatnot. That's probably the most up-to-date stuff that I post. And then subscribe and we'll see you in the next video.